If you had November 5 on your Biff bingo card, you win. Late Friday evening, the House voted to approve the $1.2 trillion bipartisan infrastructure bill, and it's now heading to the president's desk. The bill passed the House 228-206, with 13 Republicans voting for it and 6 Democrats voting against it.
It's going to create more jobs, good-paying jobs, union jobs that can't be outsourced, and they're going to transform our transportation system with the most significant investments in passenger rail, the most significant investment in 50 years, in roads and bridges, the most significant investment in 70 years, and more investment in public transit than we've ever made, period.
The 6 Democrats who voted against the bill are all very progressive and said they didn't want to vote on the physical infrastructure bill until there was a promise from the Senate that the companion social spending bill would also pass. The House Friday agreed to terms for that $1.75 trillion Build Back Better bill on a party line vote. But once again, the Dem divide hit hard, with some of the more conservative Democrats saying they wouldn't vote on the bill itself without having the nonpartisan Congressional Budget Office analyze the bill. The White House says President Biden plans to sign BIF. He's also still lobbying for the bill, heading to Baltimore this week to talk about how BIF will impact ports like the one there and also addressing supply chain problems we've been facing. Straight from DC, I'm Annie Anderson.